Hey guys, it's Di, and this is going to be more of like a vlog chat type video today, so if that's not something that you're particularly into, you might want to go ahead and just skip over this one. But I thought I would answer the question, how I became a stay-at-home mom. I've had a few comments here and there along the way, and then someone also recently mentioned that she would be interested in hearing kind of my background and how I got to where I am today from being a stay-at-home mom herself. And so I thought I would go ahead and just do a little chat on that today, and also say this could almost be like a tag video if you are a stay-at-home mom and you do videos as well, or even if you've never done a video before and would just like to do this one. I think it's a really interesting question to see how women from all kinds of different backgrounds and educations and all those sorts of things make the decision to stay at home. So if you'd like to do this video, please do, and send it to me as a video response or let me know about it. I would love to watch it and hear how you got to being a stay-at-home mom as well. So basically, I guess I will start with the mini story of how my husband and I met. We met in college, and we dated for a few years before I graduated 1 year before him. He was in the military before he was in college, so even though he is older than I am, he graduated a year after I did in college. And so we dated for a few years before I graduated, and we talked about, you know, the eventual future, even though we weren't talking marriage or anything like that at that point. And we both knew and really kind of decided, I think, at that point that if it was financially possible and something that we were able to do, we definitely wanted to have a stay-at-home mom situation after we had kids. So it's always been something that's been on the table. It's always been something that both my husband and myself agreed upon, and it's always been in the plan, really. If we were fortunate enough to be able to make the decision for me to stay at home, it's been in the plan. I've always been willing to kind of take that break in my career, and I, you know, it's something I've always had in the back of my mind. So I just wanted to throw all that out there kind of first of all, so it wasn't really something I had to mull over before we had kids. So after college, I, you know, went on a number of job interviews and was really kind of searching out, trying to figure out what I was going to do. I had a bachelor's of science in marketing, and I minored in coaching dance, which was in the physical education department. So all those kind of athletic training and dance classes and coaching and all that sorts of things. I had been a dance instructor for a number of years. I was a competitive team coach. My specialization was jazz and pom teams. So we would go to these like large competitions and compete against other groups and win awards. It was very, very fun, and team coach was one of my, you know, favorite things to do at the time, as well as putting together like large productions and that sort of thing. So that was all very fun, and so I was trying to decide what to do after I graduated from my undergrad. The opportunity became available to me that there was a town where my sister happened to live that the dance studio owner was actually leaving because her husband got transferred, and they now had the need for a dance studio. And my nieces, who were in grade school at the time, also lived there. So I had the amazing opportunity to go open my own dance studio. I did this as an entrepreneur. I started a business from scratch. I didn't take over a business or anything. I, you know, went and found a new location, started a new business plan, new business name, and my husband, now my boyfriend at the time, actually helped me build the whole interior of the place, put down dance flooring, and we had people come put up the mirrors. The whole inside had to be painted. And so really looking back on it, it was really kind of an amazing undertaking, being like just a few months out of undergrad. I graduated in May, and I started working on the dance studio in July to open in like the end of August, beginning of September. And that time period, it just seemed so right at the time that now looking back on it, I probably would tell myself, you're crazy, I can't believe you're doing this. But it was so much fun. I had amazing, amazing dancers that I taught. I'm still connected with a number of them on Facebook. They made a huge impression in my life, and I would love to hope to think that I've made a slight impression in theirs. So we just had a fantastic time with it. I taught ages 3 to adult classes, and I also did the team competitive environment where we put together special teams and took them to dance competitions in the Chicagoland area. So that was a lot of fun. My husband graduated with his undergrad degree a year after I did. So I've been running the dance studio for a year at that point. And at that point, he proposed to me and we ended up getting married. I didn't really have to do much wedding planning because I pretty much, A, already knew what I wanted. It was very simple, very easy. And also, he'd kind of been talking about marriage for a while, so the proposal wasn't exactly, a huge surprise. I kind of already knew what my ring looked like. He wanted to double check it, which I don't mind at all because I love it. And so he proposed, and pretty much within a matter of a few months, I was able to have the wedding entirely put together, and I was able to get married before the next dance season, which worked out perfectly because I did not want to be planning a wedding, and that, you know, how that can all kind of get enormous and out of hand, and also trying to undertake the dance season and going to competitions and planning dance recitals and all that sorts of things. So it worked out perfectly in my opinion. My family was freaking out because it happened so quickly from, you know, the time that he proposed to the time I had the wedding entirely planned. I think I really freaked a lot of people out. So if you guys want to know information about the wedding, I'll try to keep that in a separate video, not to like get on that too much, but we got married at Nashville Opryland Hotel. It was absolutely wonderful. It was exactly what I had in mind. And when you book your wedding there, they actually give you a wedding planner as well as a part of your package. So pretty much everything from point A to point B was planned for me. I literally just had to call, book it, and show up. So that was literally the kind of wedding that I needed at that point because I was so task saturated with running my own business and I was opening a new dancewear store at that point. So it really just was kind of easy breezy. I was running the dance studio and commuting at that point from the Chicago suburbs. My husband was working in Chicago. He moved into a new position which would require us to move. So at that point I had to decide, what am I going to do with the dance studio? And I really felt like I was going to have to kind of turn it over to someone else at that point. The commute was just way too far. It would have been over 2 hours, and I didn't feel like it was something that I could continue doing with that sort of drive. So I luckily was able to find someone to sell the dance studio to, and they were able to continue and keep it on going, and a number of the girls continued going there or other places if the person specialty wasn't exactly what they were looking for. But that all turned out well as far as the dance studio being able to continue on. I had to sort out what I was going to do from that point. So we moved to our new location, and it turned out to be a very good thing that I ended up selling the dance studio because I found a job in human resources at that point to utilize my business degree. I was working in this position, and about 30 days into it, pretty much right around the time of my 30-day review, when they were letting me know, you're doing a great job, we'd love to keep you, you know, around for a great time, and here's, you know, your future potential with the company. We found out my husband was getting kind of almost like a promotion in a sense, you know, bumped up to a new position, and it would require a move to Michigan. So at that point, I was only in the HR position for about 4 months, I think, total time, and I was able to give them plenty of notice. They were very disappointed because apparently they had plans for me, and I was a little bit disappointed because I was excited about starting this new opportunity and that sort of thing as well. But we moved to Michigan and, you know, settled in over there. We found an area that we really, really loved, still really love it to this day. You know, it's one of the few places in this world I felt like I was at home. Once we were in Michigan, I thought I would try to find, you know, some sort of career job, and it just was not going well. I couldn't find something that really worked for me. It just, there wasn't anything that was really clicking. And I went over to a university that was near us. I'd been mulling for a long time. In fact, I looked at colleges and universities in the Chicagoland area, but just felt like it was too much to take on because I was running my dance studio at that point. And so I found a university. It just really felt right. So I submitted my application to grad school. And I was accepted into the grad school and found out a few months after I was accepted, I also got accepted for a graduate research assistantship. So everything just started kind of falling into place. And I was able to start my Master's of Business Administration, and I worked for the university in the capacity of being a graduate research assistant for the marketing department. And basically, as a graduate research assistant, I would do exactly how the name sounds. I would help the professors in the marketing department with research. research. I would do the research on specific projects that they were working on and compile it together. I'd help them out with their PowerPoint presentations and notes for classes, and then also just help with other things going on in the graduate school. So that was my main function as a graduate research assistant, and that was a really wonderful, wonderful job. And then from that job, I became affiliated with a consulting company that was in the area and started a graduate research internship over the summer, which I did in combination the next fall with my graduate research assistantship, working at the consulting firm and then also doing the graduate research assistantship. So I got a lot of great experience, and it was something that was extremely interesting to me. So I graduated with my master's of business administration in December of 2008, and I actually graduated a little bit quicker than I could have. I went through every single semester back to back, not taking any summers or springtime periods off. And so I graduated in a year and a half with my graduate degree, even though it should have taken me closer to 2 to 3 years to graduate with it. And in hindsight, that's probably one thing that I definitely would change. Just given the horrible timing of when I graduated, I should have just taken the regular amount of time that it takes to finish a graduate degree and just slowed down a little bit and not overloaded myself with classes and courses, and should have just graduated in the normal amount of time that someone graduates with the graduate degree in. I ended up graduating in December of 2008. Which was 2 months after the market collapsed and the beginning of the worst recession that we've had in my lifetime. I literally graduated and companies around me were laying off 20,000 people at a time. It was a horrible, horrible time for Michigan. I mean, the atmosphere there was, it was like nothing I've ever seen in my life. It was very like just stiff and very still. Like, people were just walking around. You could see the fear on their faces, like, am I gonna go to work tomorrow and get laid off? It was just a very kind of tense environment in 2008, at the end of 2008. And it took Michigan probably, I would say, at least a year or two to even kind of bounce back from that even a little bit. So that whole year, I started searching for a job, but I knew that the prospects were not great. I was, you know, in a market with a lot of other people that had a lot of years of work experience that had recently been laid off and were all looking for jobs. And luckily, we were fortunate enough that it did not affect my husband for that, obviously. But I was not able to find a job during that time period in a regular sense, so I went back to teaching dance. And so I started teaching dance at a few local places, and teaching dance is great because you make a great wage, but you never actually get up to 40 hours, so it's never like an actual full-time wage. It's kind of more of a part-time job. So I was working part-time for a little while, and that is when I found out I was pregnant with Isabella. So I found out I was pregnant with her. I was pregnant for the majority of a dance season. I had her in May and finished out recital in June, and then I basically started being a stay-at-home mom. So that's kind of everything in a nutshell. And so, like I said from the beginning, it's always been a little bit planned. It's always been, you know, kind of what my husband and myself had in the back of our minds for if we're in the situation that I could stay at home. And we have been, luckily, that, you know, it's something that we both wanted for them while they were younger, before they went off to kindergarten and grade school. I do have, you know, aspirations of going back into the career world once they're back at school full time, and or not back at school, once they're in school full time. I'd like to, you know, get back in the working world, get back into career life a little bit, and start up my own career a little bit again, and whatever aspect that really kind of ends up. For now, this is where I'm at, and I'm pretty much planning and thinking I'll be a stay-at-home mom for at least the next 3 years or so. You know, Natalie's about 1.5 now, so realistically, at least the next 2 to 3 years, I'll be a stay-at-home mom. So this is my job title, Mommy, and that is what I will be up to. So that's how I ended up being a stay-at-home mom, and obviously I've been a stay-at-home mom since I had Isabella in May of 2010, and so going on 3 years now, I've been at home. And of course, I've had periods in there where I was kind of like a housewife, you know, in between when we were moving and that sort of thing, when we were moving from my husband's career. His career has always kind of been the lead of our household. Do have career aspirations. You know, with us having the idea of me being a stay-at-home mom at some point, I knew that his career had to be put first in certain aspects to you know, not really put it any other way. And so hopefully at some point one day our careers will line up and we will be a dual income household again. That will be that. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed this video. I feel like it was slightly rambly and probably will take a lot of editing, but pretty much how I came about being a stay-at-home mom. So if you guys have a similar video out there or would like to do it on your own, please send it to me as a video response or let me know about it, and I'd love to watch it as well. So thanks so much for watching and have a great day.